Welcome to Communication Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain vestigial sideband generation. So, to generate vestigial sideband, this is basic block diagram where we have modulating signal, that is low frequency modulating signal. Let us say this low frequency modulating signal is XT. And as I have said, it is low frequency modulating signal. So one can see over here with respect to time, that signal is having low frequency signal like this, right? Now here is carrier signal, that is high frequency carrier signal. So that is CT, that will be AC cos omega CT. If you see that signal, then that is high frequency carrier signal. So with respect to time, this amplitude vary with fast frequency like this. So this two signal, modulating signal and carrier signal, that we give it to product modulator. So we will be having output, that will be DSBSC output over here. So DSBSC output, that will get generated after having multiplication of this two. So if we see that output, so output of product modulator, output of product modulator, if I say that is YT, then that YT will be XT into CT. Now see, after having multiplication of these two signal, it is generating DSBSA signal that I have already told you. And if you see its frequency response, then in terms of frequency, I need to write it as per Y of F, and that will be AC by 2 into X of FC minus F0 plus FC plus F0. So ultimately it has two frequency component. This is low LSB frequency component and this is USB frequency component. This is lower sideband frequency component and this is upper sideband frequency component. So that is how DSBSC signal that is getting generated. Now if I say I have USB filter and frequency response of USB filter, that is H of F. So after passing through this USB filter, if I say my output is Y dash of T, then that Y dash of T, that will be multiplication of frequency response of USB filter into DSBSC input. So output of USB filter, output of VSB filter, vestigial sideband filter, that will be, let us say, Y dash of F. So that is Y of F into H of F. Now we have already seen what is Y of F, that is DSBSC output. So just place this. So ultimately our generated signal, that will be AC by 2 into X of FC minus F0 plus F X of FC plus F0, that into H of F, where H of F is frequency response of VSB vestigial sideband. So that is how we'll be able to generate VSB signal over here. Now see, if we see its frequency response, then that will gives you clear idea about it. Like see, modulating signal, that is low frequency signal that is having frequency from 0 to, let us say, bandwidth B. So in frequency domain representation, we'll be representing it like this. In negative frequency, it will be 0 to minus B. This is just a representation. And in positive frequency, it is 0 to B. So ultimately, bandwidth is B. Now, what will be the response which is there with vestigial sideband? Now, before I explain response of vestigial sideband, I think I should explain you DSBSC frequency response. So DSBSC frequency response, that will be two sidebands. So we have already seen that, you can see my previous session. So by multiplying two signals, we'll be having DSBSC response like this, where this is carrier frequency FC, this is FC plus B, and this is FC minus B. That is how response will be there. And over here in negative frequency, it is just a representation, minus FC is minus of FC minus minus B, and this is minus of FC plus B. So that will be DSBSC response. I'm just mentioning it by this color, it is DSBSC response. Now in VSB vestigial sideband, when we transmit signal by vestigial sideband, we only send one band plus vestigial band. If I say I want to send upper sideband, so this is what upper sideband, this is upper sideband plus vestigial band, so its response will be somewhat this. This is vestigial band and this is upper sideband. So total VSB is, let us say this is what, FC minus FV. So this much amount of bandwidth, that is FV, and this is what, bandwidth B. So total bandwidth, that is bandwidth plus vestigial bandwidth FV. So in negative frequency representation, even we should represent it in that way, where this is what, FV, and this is bandwidth B. So total bandwidth is FV plus B. So that will be the total bandwidth which is there with vestigial sideband. So this is how we generate vestigial sideband. Now there could be some questions like how we should design this USB filter. So I'll explain that, but let us complete this part first regarding block diagram. Again, let us have a quick revision. In product modulator, we give modulating signal and carrier signal. We multiply these two, that results into DSBSC signal. Then after, we just pass it through vestigial sideband, it will be generating VSB signal. Now this signal is weak, so we just pass it through linear filter. And once we pass it through linear filter, sorry, that VSB filter, then after we should pass it through linear amplifier, and then we send it by antenna. So this is the basic process that we do here. Now how we should design vestigial sideband filter, so let us try to understand this. Now to explain this, what I'll be doing is I'll be showing you USB upper sideband first. So if I say I have upper sideband response like this, where this is FC and this is FC plus B, this is minus FC and this is minus of FC plus B. Now here this magnitude is 1. Now if you see the response of bandpass filter, so that bandpass filter response, that will appear like this. You can see that response. Now what we need to do is we just fold it. If we fold it with respect to this carrier, if this response, which is what, vestigial response, if we fold it with respect to carrier, then it will appear over here like this. Now if I say this is curve 1 and this is curve 2, and if you add both of the curve, 1 plus 2, it should make magnitude is equals to 1. So it should make magnitude is equals to 1. That is how we should be designing VSB filter. So these two curve folded with respect to carrier frequency and response of bandpass filter, if we add these two curve, that will be resulting into this magnitude. That is how we should be designing it, where here this is what, frequency FC minus Fv. So this much amount of magnitude of frequency, that is Fv, and this is what bandwidth B. So total bandwidth is Fv plus total bandwidth, that will be bandwidth of modulating signal plus bandwidth of vestigial sideband. When we talk about what will be that vestigial bandwidth, then that will be about vestigial bandwidth, then that is about 25 to 33% of one sideband. So this will be the vestigial bandwidth that we usually choose when we send signal by VSB. Now I'll explain you few basics which is so essential in explanation of application. So when we talk about applications of VSB, then we use this VSB in TV transmission. So VSB, that is what we are using in TV transmission. Now in TV transmission, we send audio plus video signal. So in TV transmission, we send signal, that is audio plus video. Now when we talk about bandwidth of video signal, then bandwidth of video signal, that is 4.2 megahertz. So as if you send this video signal by DSB FC, so by DSB FC, that bandwidth will be, in that there will be two sidebands, so that will be twice of 4.2 plus guard band plus audio band. So if you calculate this, it will be somewhat around 9 megahertz. So 9 megahertz that we send it by DSB FC. But when we talk about by VSB, vestigial sideband, then by VSB, vestigial sideband, that bandwidth is about 6 megahertz. So here we save very broad amount of bandwidth. The reason is there are so many TV channels, and if you save 3 megahertz bandwidth in every TV channel, then that bandwidth will be very large. So by VSB we save very good amount of bandwidth, and I'll explain that how we send that signal. So let us try to understand this. Now see, I'm just scaling frequency. So I'm just showing it with respect to zero frequency. So if I say over here frequency is zero, then you'll be finding its response is somewhat this. Now in this response, if I say this is carrier, then over here this is 0.5 megahertz, carrier is at 1.25 megahertz, over here this frequency, that is 5.25 megahertz, this frequency, that is 5.75 megahertz, and over here it is 6 megahertz. Now I'll explain you how this frequency is there. See, this is for one sideband, 1.25 to 5.75, we send one sideband. This is vestigial band. And over here, we send sound signal, sound carrier of bandwidth about 50 kilohertz. So combination of one sideband plus vestigial band plus sound carrier, that is resulting into total bandwidth of 6 megahertz. So this is what total bandwidth that we send it in TV signal transmission, which is about 6 megahertz. So here we save 3 megahertz bandwidth by VSB, and this is what practical application, which is where we are using VSB right now. So this is what all about VSB, vestigial sideband modulation. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give me your valuable suggestions. It is highly required to me, and based on your suggestions, definitely I'll place videos in future. Thank you so much for watching this video.